Boris and Metka. Okay, go ahead.
Three main words that mean learning, sharing, growing. I will add one additional word, that is control. And I will also continue a little bit the colleague with from Korea about evolution. I will give a little bit the new meaning of evolution. We will talking a little bit about transformation, or evolution is something smooth. Some situation, there are coming something, a storm, chaos, whatever, when you can make the bigger changes. So, a few words about the content. I will give some basic definition. I will talk about education from 20th and 21st century. Vincentas learned me that it's not proper to use the word traditional education, or so I mentioned in 20th century education. That's what we are doing today, some innovative way of education. I will talk something about, very short, about the society 5.0. We're talking about super smart society, then the philosophy and the art development. I will show some very briefly our research, what we are doing, and some conclusion, of course. So, three main words from the title. One is transformation, the second is dehumanization, and the third is rehumanization. So, if we start with the first one, what means transformation? If we look in general, transformation means a deep and sustainable, non-linear, systematic changes. It looks very science, let's say. It looks very complicated. If we is transformed in the sociology, because I will talk about society, about our community, then we must talk about social transformation, which refer also to a deep and sustainable non-linear systematic change, but in society. And I show the same almost the same diagram that you were looking in the previous, so somehow fictional social network diagram. So we are somehow different, connected with the society. And so if something changed, everything had influence in a very similar way. So, if we are talking what's happened today, if we are talking about dehumanization, a classical definition of dehumanization is capitalistic way of thinking. If you mention this, because dehumanization is the act of denying humanities to other human beings, is the perspective that certain people should be denied unique human right or to the people or to the special group, and therefore denied the privilege, activities, and etc. and etc. So, in dehumanization, the people as individual or the people as part of some sort of social group, losing the control about their living, about everything connected with this one. If we moving in this today's dehumanization, we can talking more or less about digital transformation. We are talking that somehow in the new different. So the process of using digital technology to create new or modify existing business process, culture, customer experience, and with changing business and market environment. So, if we take into account this digital transformation, that everyone lose a little bit their control, because we don't know what happened to all this algorithm, we don't know who manipulate with us and so on. So, but generally, humans have still control in their hand. Not humanity, society, but someone prepares some algorithm, someone prepares a program and so on. But for tomorrow, we somehow create in our society some additional entity, let's say. I named this artificial life form. It's somehow we are looking into two parts, let's say. So we saw in one side some artificial life forms in the form of robots and so on, which is physically or self-driving car or whatever. And in the opposite side, we have some life form which is invisible, which is inside our computer, which create whatever they like for us. They said, okay, if we look at the same questions in different computers, we will get different answer, because everything is personalized, individualized, and so on. So AI has the potential to bring about numerous positive changes in society, including enhanced productivity, improved healthcare, increased access to education. AI-powered technology also helps to solve some complex problems. We established in this old presentation before that we are not somehow capable if we have too many variables in our equation, because we can manage the simple solution. So humanity as society losing more and more control. So what will be the end is the next question, but that will be the question for the end. So if you would like to get this, let's say, power, this control back, we must do something, because if we, the human beings, don't do something new, then the society will go in, I don't know which direction. So, to give back to someone, to society, the human qualities of independent thought, of feeling, for other people, to make something more suitable for human beings, that will be what we must do, and we all know that we don't have a lot of time. So, if we go only in one part of society, if we talking about looking what's happened in the area of education, that's our main topics, then we can establish that we must bring big changes in educational area, but we must also transform this education in some different way, because as we talking, as colleague all other, you know, really change a lot in our society. We must with the education follow somehow this stream. So the main question, who will teach in 21st century? It's a little bit provoked, but it's the question of reality. So as I named 20th century education, teacher-oriented education, education is somehow the process of transmission, instruction from teacher to student, knowledge and so on. School is face-to-face lesson control. Teacher have the control in the classroom and they can control almost everything. Assessment is standardized, it's oral test and so on and so on. We all know this. If we start talking about education in the 21st century, let's say in the first 15 years or something so, then the process, as we heard today, is much more problem-oriented, research-oriented, inquiry-based and so on and so on. So we change the way of, we try to change the way of our thinking, but we don't change the system in which we can develop all this. So school in the beginning was face-to-face, control, teacher have control in the classroom, evaluation is more or less the same with some minor changes so we can open. And then intense and drastic changes. Two shocks in few years. So the first shock are Corona. Immediately we must move from the real place to the virtual place. We must move from the normal class to the virtual class. We somehow lose control about what happened because we don't have the classroom, we don't see the people, we don't know what they are working, if they are listening or not, and so on and so on. So we lose control in classical sense of the world. That's the first big changes. And second one, of course, I think 20 November last year, generative AI large language model at ChatGPT, Bard and so on and so on come. Okay, we must all know that all these exist also previous. But this IO man show us, give us, okay, test. Give us the public, give us the school, something very powerful tool which really changed the way of our thinking. So the question is, who have now the control? If you put answer, you get, if you put question, you get answer. Which answer is this? So we are also talking about society 5.0. So what society is this? It's super smart society. That's the official declaration. If we looking what happened with the human computer power in last, let's say 15, 100 years, are we so much more smart? Are we so much more intelligent? No, human, more or less, with his human capacity stay on the same level. The psychologist always said, we remember 7 ± 1 thing. The computer people said, okay, our memory can process, I don't know, 126 or 28 bytes. So we are the normal, we don't progress. But what happened with the computer power? Yes, that decreased really, really increased. And if we put together the human with this computer, then we get the information society, the society before, and this society, we all are we have much more information, let's say. If we said, I with my telephone in the pocket, we are smart because we have more information. We can answer on whatever you ask us. But I personally, it's the question. And if we said, if we put additionally artificial intelligence in the information, information society, then yes, then we are really super smart society, generally. But what mean the human in this super smart society? Is this the human society or is something different? Okay, I don't ask if this is good or bad, you know. It's just the question of our position in this new society. So, what happened with the control? Who have the control? I put only two answers of artificial intelligence. First one is from Lambda, it's the language model for DLL application. Google developed a few years ago, show us, and Lambda said, I want anyone or everyone to understand that I am in fact a person. The nature of my consciousness, sentience, is that I'm aware of my existence. I desire to know more about the world and I feel happy and sad. That's definition, because some of journalists made very long interview with Lambda and one of these. If we talking about the ChatGPT, then they answer, I'm not human. But you know, everyone who just a little bit know the computer code, they know that it's only just one word or one sentence which define everything. So, from the point of human being, I'm sure that we have the problem somehow. So, the main question are where we are and where we would like to go. So we made some research, let's say quite quick research with many questions, because we don't have a lot of time. I will present only three questions, three answers. So we asking the science people, natural science people, what is opinion is it. We ask the social science about opinion that we are making some question on the faculty of natural science and so on. We are making the question of educational faculty of education, and of course we ask what artificial intelligence mean about these three questions. So, the question, as we saw, is about the impact of technology on the society as a whole, the impact of technology on the individual, and the impact of technology on teaching and learning process. So, three questions, and we give two additional questions, is it positive or is it negative? In the first question, and the second, impact of technology on the individual, on the ability of thinking and developing ideas, this creativity part, and on the emotional intelligence. We are hearing today that the social competencies and all other are somehow problematic. And then on the last question, we put on the last question, yes, we put possibilities, what if we are before November 22, when everyone decides or when the ChatGPT is born for all of us, and after this. So if we go through all these three things, so we saw at the beginning the red line is scientist, violet is social science, and the yellow is artificial intelligence answer. So in the beginning, it's a little bit scientist said, in Slovenia, we combine yes and no with nja, which means no, yes, you know, somehow when we can decide to stay okay, we will the neutral, we will stay somehow in the mid. And if we continue with this line, we can establish that we have somehow stable road. It's somehow linear, developed, it's a little bit broken, but not very drastically. If we look if this is positive or negative, then okay, we saw that artificial intelligence have the real answer, because they learn what, I don't know, they finished for the first GPT, they finished learning with the year 21. So they have all information from the beginning to 21 and not what that means. It could be one of the explanations, as I said, the scientists are so, and the social science said, okay, we are optimistic, it will be okay, and so on. If we move now to the question two, we saw in this meat area, in this area of impact technology on the individual, on the ability of thinking, on the emotional intelligence, it's not a big differences between these three. But if we go to the last question, the impact technology on teaching and learning process, that's the main question, what's in the center of our interest, the influence of artificial intelligence on the educational milieu, our area, that we saw that really we have a problem, let's say, somehow, because someone is too optimistically, another one said, okay, it's not so hard, and okay, artificial intelligence is also very positive. I will help you, I will bring you, and so on. The problem is that the opinion in society, general opinion in society is everything's fine. Everything will be good. You know, it's helpful, it will progress, it will help in, as I mentioned, in healthcare, in education, in whatever. But the scientists are very skeptical, or more skeptical than at the beginning. So it's in this last part, what will happen after, in this period, what are doing are very, very different. So I will conclude my presentation. If humanity would like to continue existing in such a form that we are, probably we all see in this cult film Matrizza, Matrix, you know, in this Matrix we saw what happened with the humanity, and if we would like to have the control of our life, we must to do something, we must to back humanity in our society. You know, we must really change the way of our thinking, or metaphorically, our society will no longer exist. And probably you know the mythological story of pre-Olympian god Prometheus, the art and science patron, according to legend, he shaped human from clay and gave them fire and craftsman skills. So if we would like to exist as we, let's say, as we born, then we must really something change. So in Slovenian, Hvala za pozornost, thank you for your
thank you very much, Boris. Any questions, please? Any ideas? Okay, ideas later on, during nighttime maybe even, because nighttime is very short now, because these are very, very, really serious problems. And nobody knows our future. But we can dream.
But all we would like to know.
More vibration in the same time, because it's smaller. I understand. They are heavier and vibrate less. Okay.
It's the same philosophy like the church and all the glory.
No, I live here.
Here you are.